In this video, I'm going to show you how to automatically add labels to your incoming Google Workspace emails using the power of ChatGPT. Hi, my name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation and AI to their business. I recently came across a Zapier blog called How to Automatically Label Emails with ChatGPT and Zapier. And since I'm more of a Make fan, I wanted to attempt to build this with Make. This automation will watch incoming email and ask ChatGPT to analyze the email content and make a decision on which predetermined label you want to assign to that email. Just a note, this is going to work with Google Workspace emails, but it's not going to work with a free Gmail or Google Mail email address because of the differences in their security measures. Also, you'll need an OpenAI account to make this work. I'm not going to cover that in this video, but it's pretty easy to set up. Okay, I have created a template to this scenario that I've built, and I've dropped the link down in the description of this video. So you can actually go click on that and add it to your Make account and then work through the steps of setting it up. I'm going to walk through each step and exactly how it works so you know what you're dealing with when you set that up on your account. All right, so this is our trigger step, and this is the watch emails. And so this is going to get new email. I have it set to run every 30 minutes. And I have the maximum number of results set to 350. I want that number to be larger than the amount of email I get in a half hour. I don't think I quite get 350, but I get a lot sometimes. So I just want to make sure that is set high enough. The folder we're going to be checking is our inbox. I did a filter type and I'm doing the query in inbox. Basically, that's saying look in the inbox twice. And then mark the messages as read when fetched. I'm going to leave that empty, and that's going to actually not change them to read or unread when they're fetched by the scenario. Here I'm doing a replace with regular expressions. The reason I'm doing this is some of these emails are fairly lengthy. I'm giving ChatGPT the text version of the email, and some of these emails have a lot of links in them because they're tracking links because they're coming through Gmail. And so I wanted to strip out the links because those aren't very helpful in telling ChatGPT what the email is about. And it also makes the character count of the emails really large. And sometimes you'll get an email that's just too big for ChatGPT to process because the number of characters is just too long. It's beyond its limit. So this is a pattern that is going to look for any links, and then I'm going to replace those links with an empty string. Basically, we're going to just strip those out. I've got global match to yes because I want it to replace as many links as there are, and I have the rest of these set to no, and it's working fine for my scenario. All right, over here in my ChatGPT step, you'll notice I've got a long prompt here. And this was actually the prompt that I was able to see in the screenshots of the Zapier blog post. And so I essentially replicate it pretty closely. Read the following email and sort it into one of these following categories. You can modify this to meet your needs and put whatever categories in here. Just give it the instructions and use human terms of what you want it to match. And then down here at the bottom, here is the email text content, and I've mapped the text version from our remove links replace module, which is pulling from the text version of our email. The other thing I did, I put an error handler here off of ChatGPT, just in case there's an error or something happens. Next, I'm going to set my label. So what I have coming from ChatGPT is these uppercase values, sales, urgent, newsletters. And so what I've done is I've gone over and I've created those labels in my Google Workspace account. Now you notice I put periods in front of them, and the reason is in the alphabetical sorting of the labels, these are all going to be at the top. So right up here is my labels to add. So I'm on the modify email labels module with Google Workspace Mail. I've mapped my message ID, and then I've done a switch here. And switch is a really helpful function. If you've never used it before, I would look it up and read the documentation about it. Switch gives us the opportunity to take those values. So it's going to say, here's the value from ChatGPT. And if that value is action, replace it with this label ID. And you're like, okay, where do I get the label IDs? Here's a little trick. We're going to be using the labels to add and putting this switch, but under the labels to remove, we can actually click one of those, flip this to map, and you can see there's the label value. So you can use this box at the bottom to find the label IDs for your new labels. So when this comes through from ChatGPT, it's going to be a word, and then the switch is going to change it from that word to that label. So that's it for the scenario itself. If this was helpful to you and you appreciate me creating this and giving you a template to add this to your Make account, then I would appreciate a like on this video and consider subscribing. When you do that, it tells the YouTube algorithm that this video is helpful to you and it will push it out to other entrepreneurs. So I've run the scenario and we've processed some emails here, and this one is WordPress. So let's look at email number 7 and see what that looks like. All right, so this email is from a WordFence plugin for one of my websites. So ChatGPT labeled that as WordPress, and that's a really good fit for this. This one got tagged newsletters, so that's bundle number 3. So let's go look at the text of that one. All right, this is a good fit. So this is a email newsletter I've received, and in my instructions of ChatGPT, I said, look for an unsubscribe link, and that's what makes it a newsletter. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I'd be curious to hear any comments you have about using this in your workflow to help tame your inbox, and see if this is something that you will implement to help manage and organize the emails you receive. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.